bookmark the praise, amen. Just bookmark it. And we can go back and rest. Word of God today is coming from 1 Kings, the 18th chapter, verses 41 through 46. 1 Kings, 18th chapter, verses 41 through 46. This is what the scripture says. Then Elijah said to Ahab, go and enjoy a good meal. For I hear a mighty rainstorm coming. So Ahab prepared a feast, but Elijah climbed to the top of Mount Carmel.
Yes, he did. Yes, he did.
Fell to the ground and prayed.
That's what God never wrong.
He said to his servants, go and look out toward the sea.
Yeah, he said, yeah.
The servant went and looked, but he returned to Elijah and said, I don't see anything.
That's right.
Seven times Elijah told him to go and look, and seven times he went.
That's a good one. That's a good.
Finally, the seventh time, the servant told him, I saw the cloud about the size of a hand rising from the sea. Then Elijah shouted, hurry to Ahab and tell him, climb into your chariot and go back home. If you don't hurry, the rain will stop you.
Yes, sir.
And sure enough, the sky was soon black with clouds. A heavy wind brought a terrific rainstorm, and Ahab left quickly for Jezreel. Now the Lord gave special strength to Elijah. He tucked his cloak into his belt and ran ahead of Ahab's chariot all the way to the entrance of Jezreel. Now the day word is, make it rain.
Make it rain. Tell us what.
Make it rain.
Without the rain, there is no harvest.
Yes, sir.
Without a harvest, the land slowly dies.
Yes, sir.
Many of our churches are on a slow decline to death, caused by a lack of harvest. As I prepared this message, this thought came to my mind. Without the rain, there is no harvest. I thought it must be a scripture.
Yes, sir.
But I couldn't find the scripture. But while searching, God showed me Amos chapter 4 and verse 7. In Amos chapter 4 and verse 7, it says, and this is God, I kept the rain from falling when you needed it the most, ruining all your crops. I sent rain on one town, but withheld it from another. Rain fell on one field, while another field withered away. I don't know about you, but that shook my soul. God directs the rain.
Yes, sir.
And the rain produces the harvest.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
God directs the rain.
Yes, sir.
And the rain produces the harvest. Somebody still missing. But let me say it this way. Some folks are wondering why me. Why does God seem to be holding up my harvest? Why does God seem to be holding up my blessings and my productiveness?
Yes, sir.
Folks all around me are being elevated. Well, can I tell you that just maybe you've been spending all your time praying for the harvest when you should have been asking God for the rain?
Yes, yes, yes. Amen. Yes.
God directs the rain, and the rain produces the harvest.
Yeah, that makes sense, y'all.
In verse 41 of 1 Kings,
yes, sir.
This is what the scripture says. Then Elijah said to Ahab, go and enjoy a good meal, for I hear a mighty rainstorm coming your way. Let me explain this to
to somebody. The prophet spoke an encouraging word to the king about an upcoming rainstorm. But let me place this prophecy in its proper context.
Yes, sir.
Over in the first verse of this same chapter 18. Let me give you the context that they're in. After many months passed, in the third year of the drought,
yeah. Yes, sir.
The Lord said to Elijah, go and present yourself to King Ahab and tell him that I will soon send rain. We need to know that it had rained in 3 years. When God sends this word through the prophet to the king, we panic when it doesn't rain for 3 months. I remember just a couple weeks ago when we had the building removed in the St. Paul Park and the dirt was so dry. And I was complaining, Lord, please send some rain. Dirt too dry. Told my man, I said, God, we need to put some grass out. We need to put some seed out. We got to pray for some rain.
All right.
Well. We complain when it doesn't rain for 3 months.
All right.
These folk hadn't seen rain in 3 years. And a famine is sweeping all throughout the land. But God uses the prophet to deliver a word to the king. He says, go on and enjoy your life because I hear a mighty rainstorm coming your way.
Yep.
I told me to tell somebody in here today, I know what you're going through. I know how long you've been going through.
Yes, sir.
But God told me to tell you, go on and enjoy your life because I hear a mighty rainstorm coming your way. In verse 42,
yes, sir.
Chapter 18, Elijah, he begins to pray for rain.
Yeah.
You can't just hear a word. You got to start doing some things to make the word come to pass.
Yes. Yes.
And so the first thing that Elijah begins to do is he begins to pray for rain.
Uh-huh.
The scripture says that Ahab received the word. But can I tell you, a lot of things that I tell y'all are going to happen, I really don't know how it's going to happen. God just put it in my spirit and say it's going to happen. And when I tell y'all, I still don't have the answers. And the Bible said that King Ahab got a word, and he began to prepare a feast, even though they hadn't had a feast in 3 years. At his word. And he begins to prepare for a feast. Because in his heart he knows that it ain't the prophet that has the power. The prophet is just the postman that's delivering a message from the God that controls the feast. From the God that controls the harvest. And from the God that controls the rain. And so he begins to prepare a feast. But then Elijah realized, now it's time for me to go to work. I can't just speak this word and then go sit down and watch God do it. What God does. That's how a lot of Christians do it. They go sit down and wait for God to do what God does. But no, 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 it's going to take a little work on your part. God put it in the eye. But we got to do some things to nurture it. God put it in the eye. But we got to do some things to encourage it. God put it in the eye. But we got to do some things to help it come to pass. And so the Bible says that Elijah, he climbed on top of Mount Carmel. And he said that he fell to the ground and prayed. Elijah had to go to a high place. He
He had to get out from among the reeds. He had to get out from among all the folk that's talking negative. He had to get out from all the folk that's complaining about how long it's been dry. He had to get out from all the folk with negative opinions and negative thoughts. What am I saying to you? One reason why your prayer might not be working because you down in the gutter praying next to folk that don't even believe what you're praying about. That don't believe that God is able. Praying next to folk. I tell folk all the time. I thank folk for telling me what folk are saying, what folk are doing. But the work I got before me, I don't need to be around any negative folk. They tell me, say, Pastor, I'm so glad that you trust God and that you believe God. Because if folk out there always got something negative to say, let me say y'all a few words. Don't tell me about the negative folk. Don't tell me about the doubters and the haters. Don't tell me about the folk that's always church talking the church down. That's not telling me about the Klansmen. I know they're out there. That's not telling me about the haters. I know they're out there. You ain't got to tell me they're out there. Don't pull my spirit down by sitting me down with them. I have to operate in a high place because God has a great work for us to do. God, as a matter of fact, when folk come to you in that mess, let them know that the devil is a liar. And can I say, I rebuke you and say, go back to the pits of hell. I rebuke you and take that nonsense somewhere else. Jesus had to go to a high place, but the Bible declares when he went to a high place and he got down low. Somebody say, yeah. Not saying that you're better than anybody. When you go to a high place, it's not saying that you're more special than anybody. But you go to a high place to get out the muck and the miry clay. You go to a high place to get around all the doubt and the haters and the naysayers. But when you get to the high place, you gotta learn to get low before a God that's able. You gotta learn to get low before a God that sits on the throne. Do I have any witnesses in the house? The Bible says Elisha, then he climbed to the top, but then he fell to the ground and began to pray. I can see Elijah down there saying, God, now you told me to speak a word, God. God, I don't hear any thunder in the background. You told me to speak a word to your people, God, and tell them that everything is going to be all right. But I haven't seen a rain cloud in 3 years, God. And so, God, I need you to do what you do best. Somebody say yeah. Somebody say yeah. And the Bible says that Elisha, he began to pray. But can I tell you that Elisha, he didn't stop at prayer like a lot of folk do. They sit in the church and always pray. They sit around and always talk about prayer. But the Bible declares that we have to watch as well as pray. You can't pray and close your eyes to injustice all around us. You can't pray and close your eyes to poverty all around us. You can't pray and close your eyes to homelessness all around us. But the Bible declares that we ought to watch as well as pray. And so the Bible says, not only did he pray, but in verse 33, the Bible says that Elijah, he told his servant, I need you to go out there, and I need you to look, I need you to see if the prayers are coming through. We've been praying to God, but we got to go out there and see if they're coming through. We've been praying to God, God, we need you to stop the violence. You got to go out there and see if the prayer is working.
God spoke a word in your life. Don't you give up on that word. Don't you stop respecting that word. If you got to go back 7 times, 7 days, 7 months, 7 years, or 7 days, you keep going back until you get what God told you that you can have. There are a lot of blessings still sitting out there right now, unclaimed in the atmosphere. Because we got tired, we gave up, and went on to something else. But God says, you gotta pray without cease. God says, if I said it, you got to expect it. You got to observe and see what needs to be modified. You got to expect what I promise. And the Bible declares that on the 7th day, it said that the servant came back and he told the prophet, he said, you know what? I looked out there, I hadn't seen anything. But in verse 44, you got some results. He says, finally, on the 7th time, trying to get it right, but can't get it right. Your money seems to be always running short, and you can't seem to get it right. But keep praying, and keep watching, and keep learning. God said one day, you gonna look at PetReport.com, and you gonna see a little edge up in your prayer. God said, one day, you gon' find yourself on the Friday morning of payday, with still a little bit of money in the bank, with some more coming. God said, that's just the money that I'ma show you, to let you know that I got a storm coming your way. Somebody say yeah. Somebody say yeah. Trust in God with all your heart. Lean not to your own understanding. Wait on the Lord. Be of good courage. God will bless your path. Elijah, he kept praying. The servant said, I see a cloud about the size of a hand rising in the sea. And you know what Elijah did? It wasn't even stormy yet. He didn't even feel the drop yet. But the Bible declared that Elijah, he declared that the Lord is still good. And he says he began to shout right where he is, right where he was. I don't know about you, but I don't need to see the overflow. When he gets to get a praise, I don't need to get a storm, to begin to get a praise. But if I can just see a little cloud in that way out in the sea, that's enough right there to take my heart. It's a good heart. That's enough right there to begin to get a praise.
Thank you.
the rain comes, we know how it comes. And see the rain comes, when Elijah comes, when he needs God comes, to make it rain comes, to lead me out
Thank you.